Thank you. Let's welcome my notebook too. Okay, so today I'm gonna talk you through the Vault Upgrade Hook. It's a tool you might already know from last year because Konrad Woeltke presented the concept of it last year. But today I want to show you what the current status is and how you can use it in your projects. So let's start with what does it do? It's about content migration. So we heard already about today about the different types of content we have, and one of the types was the user-generated or author-generated content. And we all have this in our projects that we roll out a new version of our application and it brings new resource types or changed resource types with it or changed data structures. So what do? We write servlets or scripts to fix that content or to upgrade this content. And the Vault Upgrade Hook is a nice and easy way to standardize those processes while using existing APIs and existing processes you have already in place. So let's have a look into the technology. So we are using a feature of JackRabbit called install hooks. It's a feature of content packages. So basically an install hook is an interface you have to implement, and it provides you the possibility to execute code during installation of content packages. And the basic concept is that you have a jar with your implementation of your install hook within your content package under the path meter-inf vault hooks, and then in our case, vault upgrade hook jar. A bit about our implementation, so just a few words about terminology and what we have at the moment. So we have like three layers, tiers, however you want to see it. We have the processor, which is the actual implementation of the install hook. So doing the magic, actually calling the right things, executing the things. Then we have the actions, which is the actual code you are providing, which does the upgrade. And we have an upgrade info, which is like, you can see it as a container for configuration. At the moment, we have different types of upgrade actions out of the box. For sure, you can implement your own, but what we already provide you is a plain Groovy scripts you can execute for migration. We have a special type of Groovy scripts executed via the Groovy console. That Groovy console brings several extensions with it, like node builders, page builders, all this stuff. So you cannot use this in plain Groovy script, but if you're using those Groovy console scripts, then you can use Sling pipes, which is a concept you might have heard of. If not, Google it. And we have a special type for upgrade actions for upgrading user preferences. So basic idea is you just provide a simple configuration and then your user preferences get updated. That can be, for example, used to get rid of those annoying welcome to AEM, did you already know of feature X, Y, Z things. So let's talk about some features we have. Main feature is the install mode. So we have two types. So if you install a content package, you can execute your code always. Will mean no matter how often you install your content package, your code gets, or your action gets executed every time. And we have an on-change mode, which is executing your code only once or if it has changed. So we are getting just a simple MD5 hash out of your content and comparing that and deciding whether to execute your action or not. We try to have minimal dependencies. So we are only dependent on JCR and JackRabbit. So In a minimal setup, you won't even need Sling or AEM for it. For sure, if you use Sling pipes, you need somehow Sling dependency in it, or also for the Groovy console, you need AEM because it's an AEM feature. And we have SLF4J, JDK 1.7, but that shouldn't normally be a problem to use it. So let's dive into a short demo. How does it look like? So I have prepared a content package here, already uploaded. And I'll just install it for now. And we will have a look into the output. So can we see that? No, we can't. So let's try to make it bigger. Doesn't work. Let's do a trick. And sorry. No. Sorry for that. Okay. But now we have something a bit bigger. So we get our standard standard upgrade stuff, and what we see, so the package had basically no content, but what we see here, we have those log messages prefixed with upgrade in here. So we have a phase prepare, phase install, phase end, and we see, okay, there got scripts executed. So on the prepare phase, we got a script always.groovy executed. And in the installed phase, we got another script here on change.groovy executed, right? So those are two scripts. We'll have a look into this in a moment. I mean, the first feature I was talking about is was this always and on change. So if I reinstall the package again, it's a bit small again, but you see only like here is only the always .groovy executed and not the onChange.groovy anymore. So let's have a look into this package, how it looks like. So basically, we have this always.groovy. For extra points, you see here, or you might see here, if I can make it a bit bigger. We have adapt2 even executed, not only on slides in this talk. So. And what does it do? It just upgrades basically a value map in the re-retail demo, and just to see. And in the re-retail, we see just okay. The always property was updated twice because I'm just incremented it, and the on change property was just upgraded, incremented once. And exactly. So let's have a look into this package. How does it look like in detail? So what do you have to do? So it's a basic content package, actually. Not much content here, but it could have also some content. You could like add this feature to every content package you like. Your apps standard apps package or something, and what we have in here under meterinf vault hooks, we have the char. So you have to take care that the char comes in there. In the project documentation, we provide you some Maven snippets how you get it there, but basically you have to put it in your content package, and additionally under definitions, you have your scripts. So basically, it's just about your build process. You're placing your scripts into the right place, and then they get executed automatically. Exactly, that's how the package looks like. To provide this feature with the only on change installation, we have to provide some state within the repository. We have this here under var upgrade and then vault upgrade hook samples. That's like basically the name of my package. And so that's the group of my package, the name of my package. And then we have those two upgrade infos, the one for always, the one for on change. And you can see here we have the the action in there with the MD5 hash appended to it. And yeah, that's just how we do. So actually, if I would now change the content of my script on the of this on-change script, package my content package again, and reinstall it, it would be installed again. So yeah, let's continue with the slides. So yeah, I just if somebody wants to look up what I just showed you later on, maybe one point I didn't mention. Yeah, if you went, for example, if you have like if you don't install via the package manager, which you don't do probably on production, you have the your log configuration. You can just configure that via your standard log config, and then getting all installation details of the upgrades in one separate file, and you can just get that or monitor that or whatever you need. And yeah, as I said, also you have under var upgrade, you have one flag also if when the last upgrade happened and was it a success or not. Additionally, also if your script fails, the content installation will fail. It's a bit dependent on your on the phase. We saw those prepare, installed, and end phase. So apparently, it's only possible to fail the package installation on prepare. But if you have a script failing on prepare, it will fail your content installation too. So your normal mechanism will like monitor and alarm you if the upgrade failed through this. Shortly about the project, it's on GitHub. We released several weeks ago in version 1.0.0, so totally stable. but we use it already on production. I mean, it's out there. The idea, as I said, it's out there several times already, and we use it in some flavors already in some projects, and also the actual release version. I use it in my project at the moment, also on production, and it's quite simple, and it works quite stable. And the beauty of it is really that you can use it with your current setup. It's just installing a content package, so a bit of Maven configuration to get the scripts in the package, and then you can just for deployment use your standard process. And I think that's really nice to use and even to try out. If you don't trust me, just set it up and try it with one script, and you will see it works fine, and then you will love it. Okay, I mean, that's already it for an overview. Do you have any questions?
Okay, so if
they're not, if not, you can always approach me or write me. Yeah. Thank you.
Perfect. Thank you very much, Andreas.